Show them we still are here, we're ruling the world, but the bar is sold out. Quadir and James Ford. They sold out the product. 59 is gone, 58 is gone, 57 is gone, and 88 is low.
Hi, my name is Shauna, and we're here at the Brunner Brothers Show. I have a mohawk going on, as you can tell, and I have the golden blonde at the top and jet black on my sides, and that's it. Is that good enough?
He's been in the contest too, it's Kevin Hart. So,
you have to be even neater. You won't want color on his lips and on his nose or anything like that. So you have to be nice and neat. And again, take the razor blade and crispy up anything that's not supposed to be there. Then after I did that, I applied the color all through his hair, and I stopped right at the bottom of, at the top of the nape. And I took the towel and I blotch tapered it, as I said earlier. And I kind of spread the color through, but at the same time, not coloring the skin, just the hair. You can still see the fade, you can still see the taper. So we're all done now. Processing time, 30 to 45 minutes. Again, I'm Jay. Thank you for using Begin. Okay, now. Finish the model's hair as exactly as I said, and I'll walk you through it right now. I'll walk you through the process. On this particular model, I went right side to left side. Okay? Now, I applied the color on the line. You see how thick it is? You want to have it nice and thick so you can have control over what you're doing. If it's runny, it'll run all in his eye. You don't want to put your client's eye out. You want to drip it on his nice clothes because he's going out tonight and he's going to make himself look good and you look good. Now, I started from the side, the right side, and I brushed it back. I use a big brush. You can use a small brush. This is the size of the brush I use right here. And this is the other brush I use right here. So both of these, you can use which one that fits you the best. I came around the temple. I didn't taper the temple. I brought it right into the beard, into the mustache. As you can see, I did it nice and neat. Went behind it with the razor. Now, when I went behind it with the razor, I just made the line, made a nice crisp definition. I didn't have to recut his hair. So when you go behind it with the razor, you're not trying to cut. You stretch the skin. Stretch the skin. And you just lift the color to make the proper line that you want to do. But if you're putting it on neatly like you're supposed to, it's not too much cleanup work you have to do. Then I went around to the other side, so that we can have some even processing time. Went around to the other side, did the same exact thing I explained before. And the towel is spreading the color for me. Exactly what, then I did the front. Now, a lot of times when you do the front, you still want to see the line, but you might want to comb it back some so that the color doesn't be on the tips of the hair and just get out of control. So I leave a nice little thick pile here so I can get control of the hairline. Once I get it nice and crispy and clean, now a lot of barbers have problems with this area here. The mustache.